Hello guys, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you the 2022 Subaru Outback Wilderness. The Wilderness is brand new for 2022, and basically this is the off-road slash adventure Outback you could buy. So I'm gonna go ahead and review it for you guys and show you all the features this Wilderness trim has. Under the hood, they're going to be a 2.4 turbocharged four-cylinder engine that is connected to a CVT transmission. This engine produces 260 horses and 277 pound-feet of torque. And the fuel economy numbers on this engine, 22 in the city, 26 highway, and 24 combined. So if you guys are curious about the color is called Crystal White, and it does look very good on this Outback Wilderness. And honestly, I would get it in white because you could see the black trims, the flat black. And if you get it in a different color, you won't be able to tell that this is the Wilderness trim. So with the white, you'll be able to tell that this is the Wilderness trim. Anyways, the price on this one is $39,000 with the options this one has, like the wheel locks, the side body moldings, and a few other things. And coming to the front, I really like what Subaru did, and I'm glad that Subaru actually is offering the off-road version of the Outback. The front looks very nice. It does have its own unique grille, and it does have a good amount of flat black. And even on the side, there's a good amount of flat black, so the fenders are very thick. And on the hood, they're going to be a black decal. The hood itself doesn't really have that aggressive lines, but it does look good. And as I said, the grille has a really nice look to it. It is finished in flat black. Subaru badge is nice and big. And for the headlights are going to be LED. And the daytime running light is LED as well, but the turn signal indicators here in the front are halogen. For almost $40,000, I really wish that Subaru made the turn signal indicators halogen. And in the bottom, the fog lights have a really nice look to them, and they are LED. They're nice and bright, and they're going to be a bottom grille, and all the way in the bottom. So basically the bottom portion of the bumper is finished in this rugged look. And overall, I think the front of this Subaru Outback looks good, and you could definitely tell that this is the Wilderness trim. But let me go ahead and move to the side, and I'll show you the side view of this Wilderness package. So here is a side view of this Wilderness trim, and it does look very good. I love what Subaru did with the fender flares. They're nice and thick and finished in flat black, and overall I think the side view looks very good on this Outback. For the rims, they're finished in gloss black, and the size is 225/65/17, so there's a good amount of rubber, and the rubber itself has an aggressive style or aggressive look. It's not basically the old season, it's basically like a mud terrain rubber. But overall, the side view looks good. There is a good amount of flat black in the bottom. There is more flat black on top of the Outback badge, and the Outback badge is finished in gold. There is a Wilderness badge on the front door. For the mirrors, they are finished in gray slash flat black, and they do have turn signal indicators. And this Outback does have the blind spot monitoring system. And on the roof, there is some roof rails. They're finished in flat black, and I think they look very good, and they give this Wilderness trim a really nice look. And the capacity weight on those roof rails are 700 pounds. The window trims are finished in flat black, and overall, everything looks very good. But let me go ahead and move to the back, and I'll show you the back of this Wilderness trim. Here is the back of this Outback, and it does look very good. And I completely forgot to mention, but this Wilderness trim has 9.5 inches of ground clearance, and honestly, getting inside and out of this Outback is very, very easy. And does have a spoiler. The side is finished in flat black. The shark fin antenna is finished in flat black. Here is the third brake light. It is LED. And for the wiper, it is located right here. I really wish that all companies start hiding the wipers right underneath the spoiler, because most of the SUVs now have spoilers. For the taillights, not everything right here in the back is LED. So the running light is LED, but the reverse and turn signal indicators are halogen. And the bumper is mostly finished in flat black. And the reflectors are located right underneath the taillights. Never really seen that. Usually the reflectors are in the bottom. Subaru with all-wheel drive badges on the left. And on the right is the Outback badge with the Wilderness badge right underneath it. And it does have the gold touches, basically this is to tell you that this is the Wilderness package, and you could actually open them and you could put like some tow hooks if you want to. And it does have dual exhaust pipes. There is no fake tips or any exhaust tips. Here is a key. It's a little bit on the bulky side, but it does feel nice and solid, and it does have four buttons on it. Lock, unlock, trunk release or tailgate release, and a panic button. It does have some brushed aluminum on the side. And this Wilderness has automatic lift gate. And this should be expected from a $40,000 car. Does have a button to close the tailgate and lock the car, and then another button to just close the tailgate. And there is actually a handle right there. Inside there is a ton of space. It is nice and wide. The opening is nice and big. And they're going to be a privacy cover. And it does have two positions. You could have it this way, or you could actually bring it up like this. But again, guys, there is a ton of room in the back. There's going to be a hook right here, a handle, some tie downs, and a storage place on the right. 12 volt and a tie down. There is more storage place on the left. Handle, more tie downs, which is nice. And underneath, they're going to be the spare tire with the jack and the jack tools, and some space right behind, or like in the back right there, for you to put a few things. But seriously, there is a ton of space in the back of this Outback. But let's go ahead and move inside, and I'll show you the inside of this Wilderness package. Here is the door handle. It does have two sensors. It does have a sensor right here. That's how you lock the car. And to unlock it, there is a sensor right behind the door handle. That's how you unlock the car. For the front door panel, it's all finished in black. The top portion right here is that synthetic rubber material. This is plastic. It does have that carbon fiber looking trim. The handle feels nice and solid. It is finished in chrome. It does say Subaru Wilderness right here. This whole thing is finished or wrapped in leather. The armrest is wrapped in leather. It does have that gold slash yellow stitching. All the window switches are automatic up and down. And for the mirror controls, they look good. Does have a speaker in the bottom. Good amount of storage place in the bottom, and a bottle holder. Plastic, which is completely fine. And seats are very nice and comfortable. They have a really nice design, and they have a lot of that gold stitching. And of course, they're powered seats, and they do have lumbar support. And on the headrest, it does say Subaru Wilderness, which is nice. And let's go ahead and move inside this Subaru, and I'll show you how it looks like from the inside. All right, so here is the interior of this 2022 Subaru Outback Wilderness. It does have the gold slash yellow touches, like on the steering wheel and on the shifter. And I really wish that Subaru made it a little bit more different than the normal Outback. It does have some gold stitching on the dash, but it's not really that visible. So I really wish that Subaru made it a little bit different than the normal Outbacks. Steering wheel looks good. It's a little bit on the bulky side. This center section right here is a little bit sticking out, a little bit big. Subaru badge is nice and big. It does have a few buttons right here in the bottom to control that middle screen. You could go up and down. And as I said, it does have that gold slash yellow trim. These stitches right here, the inner part, they're gold. And overall, I think the steering wheel looks right. And I really wish it was wrapped in leather for almost $40,000 car. On the left, there are going to be a few buttons: volume control, voice command, phone controls. Two buttons right here to toggle through the stations, basically FM, AM, and the radio controls. And on the right is basically Subaru EyeSight safety features or buttons. They're going to be the button to turn on all the safety features, adaptive cruise control, steering assist. You could adjust the gap between you and the car in front of you. You could set the cruise control, turn it on and decrease and increase the speed. And overall, very easy system to use. But again, guys, I really wish that the steering wheel was wrapped in leather for almost $40,000 car. does have some paddle shifters. This Outback does have CVT, but it does have eight modes or eight gears of manual mode. And on the left is the headlight controls with the fog light controls. And on the right is the wiper controls for the front and back. And just our stop is located right there. It is, the surrounding of it is finished in chrome, which is nice. And for the gauges, they do look good. Nothing too crazy, very easy to understand and read. And as I said, it does have this center display. You could toggle through a few things. And AC vents look good. And on the bottom, there is the power lift gate, brightness control. And this button right here, I think this is to turn off the power lift gate from the button outside or from the key. And here is a screen. It is an 11.6 inch screen. It does look all right. The graphics are a little bit on the older side. I really wish that Subaru changes the way how their system looks like, because it does definitely look a little bit on the dated side. It is an 11.6 inch screen. It does have Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, and it does have some hard buttons on the left and right, which I like. So like the temperature, volume knob, tune knob. And as I said, it does have Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. System itself is not too bad. It's a little bit on the slower side, but it's not that bad. I've seen worse. And here is the backup camera. Backup camera is okay. And here are some modes. Snow, dirt, normal, deep snow, mud. And the screen itself, the way how it's integrated into the dash, I think it does look good. There is some blacked out brushed aluminum. As I said, here are the temperature controls, but you could actually control the climate from here. So you could change the modes. You could increase the fan. You could open this up and you could use this instead of using the buttons if you want to, or you could use the buttons. So basically up to you. And it does have heated seats. It does have three stages of heated seats. I really wish that the heated seats had physical buttons, but because of the screen size, there is really no place for Subaru to put the heated seat buttons anywhere. And here is the emergency light button. It does have the AC vents right here on the side, which I think they look good. And as I said, here is the engine start stop. And you could do the same thing for the passenger, so heated seat and the temperature. And it does have the engine shut off, so when you come to complete stop, the engine will turn off. And this button right here is to basically control the traction control and the other modes. So you have the driving assistant right here. You could turn on or off the blind spot and the lane departure. A few more things right here, but you could basically turn off the traction control from here. The X mode, you could change it to snow, dirt, and mud, or when you put it in drive, actually when you put it in reverse, it should pop up there, just like that. So it does change the modes, and it will actually display it in that center display. And as I said, so you could control a few things from here. And in the bottom, that's where the electronic brake is. It does have some chrome on it, which is nice. When you activate it, the light turns on. And down there, there is two USBs with an aux and a little bit of storage place, but there is no wireless phone charger. I really wish there was for $40,000 car. Here is the shifter. It does have some gloss black. It does have that gold slash bronze slash yellow color. And this is wrapped in leather. This is all finished in gloss black. And as I said, it does have a CVT transmission, but does have the manual mode. And this button right here will turn on the camera. It does, by the way, have a front-facing camera, and it does have, of course, the backup camera. And I completely forgot to mention the front-facing camera when I was in the front. And there is two cup holders, very deep. The armrest is nice and soft. It does have that yellow stitching. Inside, there is a good amount of space. I really wish it was a little bit big, but it's not too bad. 112 volt, and it does have a first tier. You could store a few things right here, very small. And of course, there's the second tier that I showed you. Here are the cameras for Subaru EyeSight system. The rear view mirror is nice and big and almost frameless. garage controls right underneath it. It does have the auto dimming feature. And up here, glasses holder, SOS, a switch to basically keep the lights off when the doors are open. It does have some LED lights, but I really don't like the way how this button feels flimsy, very cheap. And the visor feels nice and solid. It is padded, which is nice. And there are going to be some halogen lights with a good size mirror, but there is no sunroof in this Wilderness trim. I really wish there was for $40,000. And there is this storage place right here. And the glove box is nice and big. Here is the back door panel, and of course it does look the same, but what I like is the fact that Subaru did not cheap out. So this is going to be that synthetic rubber material. This whole thing is wrapped in leather, just like the front. The armrest is nice and soft, more of that gold stitching. Window switch in the back does have that gloss black look, gloss black trim. And the door handle has a really nice weight, does have that nice trim. And good amount of storage place, bottle holder, speaker in the bottom, and back seats are nice and spacious. Good amount of leg room, and the headroom is good. And here is the armrest, does have two cup holders. The armrest is wrapped in leather, very nice and soft. And there are going to be two AC vents, heated seats in the back, two stages, and there is two USBs here in the back. And that's how the front of this Subaru Outback looks like. I hope you guys enjoyed this review of this 2022 Subaru Outback Wilderness. I would like to thank Jeff and Elmer here at Dan Perkins Subaru in Milford, Connecticut. If you guys are around and if you guys are interested, make sure to come check them out. I'm going to go ahead and put the information and link in the bottom of this video. And if you guys would like to see more videos like this, please subscribe. And as always, I'll see you next time.